Good evening, everyone. The Upper Peninsula Track and Field Finals usually have a little bit of everything. This year, the most important thing is it didn't have rain. The event stayed dry until about half an hour after the last trophy was presented. Iron Mountain broke quickly from the gates in the 110 hurdles. Aaron Bolo and Charlie Gerhard placed first and second. Bolo is a Central Michigan wrestling recruit that also took second in the long jump and placed in two other events. Gerhard won the 300 hurdles and placed in high jump and a relay. NMU football recruit Trevor Roberts of Kingsford won the 100 dash in 11.25 seconds. He anchored the winning 4x100 relay, was the runner-up in the 200 dash, and came in third in the long jump. Houghton's Clayton Sayen had three wins on the day. He took the 400 in 50.24 seconds. He added wins in the 200, the 4x800 relay, and was second in the 4x400 relay. Strangely enough, Marquette won just three events and only one running race, the 4x400 relay. Colin Shinners was the anchor. The Redmen went 1-2-3 in the high jump, led by Jedediah Weber, and Wyatt Goodwin earned the win in the long jump. Despite that, Marquette won the championship.
We came in seated a lot lower than I think we all deserved. And I think pretty much everyone went faster than they were predicted to do. I think there's a lot of PRs today, and we just ran well. Jed Weber stepped up. Alex Duvall really stepped up. He's in four events today and really killed it.
The Redmen won their sixth UP crown in the last 8 years with 128 points. Iron Mountain finished in second and Houghton in third. To Division II, where Norway's Connor Ortman shows us good starting technique. But it didn't take long for Newberry to find the finish line in the 110 hurdles. On the right, Alex Johnson edges Norway's Stankovic by 2/100ths of a second. Stankovic beat Johnson in the 300 hurdles. A number of records were set at the finals. Munising sophomore Matthew Revord cleared 13 feet, 6 inches in the pole vault. With room to spare, that made the loud and proud Stang Nation pretty happy. But in the end of it, it was Newberry taking the title.
I was in long jump, shot put, discus, in the 4x1. I was able to take first place in all my events, so that was cool. We had a great day as a team. We kind of all came together. We were able to score in every event, which is awesome. Instrument gave us a good run, but in the end, we came out on top.
Newberry racked up 130.5 points in the title run. Instrument made the century mark as well to finish second. Stevenson was in third. Let's take a look here. D3 started well for North Dickinson as Garrett O'Neill outkicks Pickford's John LaMouth and Rapid River's Mason Berglund to the finish line, the 100 hurdles. O'Neill also won the 300 hurdles and the long jump. He helped in the second place finish for the Nordics 4x200 relay team as well. Onto the 400 meter run, Rapid River's Lucas Sundling pulls away from Chassel's Grant Hokinson to win in about 52.5 seconds. He was the runner-up in the 100 and 200. The Rockets also had wins by Luke Gustafson in the pole vault and Logan Hardwick in the discus. 800-meter run, Besmer scores very well as Isaiah Ali led a 1-2-4 finish with teammates Cade Mazan and Uriah Ali. That was 22 points for the Speed Boys. Isaiah Ali earlier won the 1600. Besmer fans also were happy when Braden Tomes won the 200, edging the Rocket Sundling. Rapid River led 98-96 going into the final event, which was the 4x400 relay. The Rockets' Austin Wicklin anchored his second winning relay of the day to give the purple and gold team the title. That's two in a row for Rapid River.
We came in thinking we were supposed to be way farther ahead than we actually were. I think we were a little overconfident, but our Maya Relay boys pulled through at the end, smashed our school record and the UP record, and they just came out and did amazing things, and it was very, very fun to watch.
Rapid River defeated Besmer 108-104, with Pickford taking third.